They've got this video outfit at the university. I'm sure we can borrow it to make a tape ourselves.
You mean of me?
Yes. And you can make all the points that you made in your PRG letter, but make them personally. It'd have a lot more impact on the general public.
I suppose it would.
And what a scoop for the TV channel. A tape of an escapee is still on the loose, talking about the circumstances that forced her into escaping.
The current affairs people would jump at it.
Yeah, well, they'd give it a lot of publicity too. You get a lot of people on your side, Judy.
I like it.
Well, let's do it.
They want me to go to America?
Yes, they're waiting for you.
Oh, bloody beauty bottle.
Now, take it easy, Lizzie. Calm down.
Is everything all right?
Oh, everything's bonzo. I'm gonna live in the US of A. What do you reckon about that, eh?
Beautiful, isn't it?
It's fantastic, Wally. So quiet. You know, I must have seen 1,000 sunsets, but this one's sort of special. It's like seeing it for the first time, you know?
They don't have windows at Wentworth, huh?
They got windows all right. It's just a bit hard to focus past the bars or to take the time to look. Every time you think you have a minute to yourself, they ring a bell to tell you to get to work or to stop work or to sit down or to stand up. The only bell they don't have is one that tells you to watch the sunset.
Not the nicest place in the world to be, huh?
No, Wally, it's not. And I'm not looking forward to going back there either.
They've got to catch up with you first.
Oh, they'll do that. It's just a matter of time.
Well, it'd take a lot longer if you gave up this campaign for reforms at Wentworth, you know. Maybe they'd never catch up to you.
I couldn't do that, Wally. I couldn't turn my back on my friends inside.
Yeah, well, I understand how you feel, but...
But what?
Look, I'm going to be honest with you. I really am very, very concerned about Mickey getting involved in this. I mean, she's strong, she's determined, she fights for what she believes.
You're against that?
No, that's the way I brought her up. If there's any belief worth having, it's worth fighting for, but she doesn't need prison, reformed or otherwise.
Are you trying to tell me that if the prisoners want reform, they've got to fight for it themselves?
No, look, I'd be the first to tell her to get out there with a banner and protest, but the worst can happen about that is a fine, but getting involved with an escapee, well, she could finish up in the very prison she's trying to reform.
Yeah, charged with aiding and abetting and all that.
Yes.
You know, you could have the same charges.
I don't care about me. I'm willing to help you try and stay out of prison as long as possible because I really believe you're the sort of person worth helping.
And the other inmates aren't?
I didn't say that, but I don't know the other inmates, do I? But I do know you and I do like you and... Well, Mickey likes you. That's why I know she'll listen to anything you say.
Okay. Is there anything special you want me to say to her?
If you go ahead with this campaign, and I think you're determined to do so, I want you to tell Mickey to stay out of it. Look, she's already got a couple of fines and convictions for protest marching, for public nuisance. If they find her with you, they'll put her away for certain.
Well, I've already done all that, but you know what she's like.
All I know is she's my only daughter. She's about all I care for. Oh, well, the sun's almost set. Better light some more lamps, huh?
And you just wouldn't believe the improvement. She's as bright as a button.
All because of that letter.
Oh, and the news it contains about Ellen remarrying and wanting Lizzie to join her over there.
Pardon?
Ellen wants Lizzie to join her and Josie in the States. The fellow she's marrying is a professional man.
Yeah.
Well, what is it?
You'll have to excuse me, Meg. I have to go to court with Doreen.
Yeah, is everything all right?
Well, if Lizzie's recovery is due solely to Ellen's letter and her invitation to the States, we'll have to expect a very sudden and drastic relapse.
Why?
Lizzie is a convicted person. With a criminal record, she can't get a visa into the States.
Well, I know don't sense a nice old guy, Pete, but I
that's
still
nothing.
Don't.
Listen, if he can get a bit of extra work, it'll help stretch his pension. Now, what have we got lined up so far?
Oh, a couple of block drains and a neon light to be fixed.
Yeah, well, that'll do for today. Now, tomorrow...
Ah, oh, good morning, Mrs. Morris.
Morning. Everything okay here?
Yeah, we're fine, but you don't look so hot. What's the worry?
It's Lizzie.
What is it? The last we heard, she was doing fine.
Well, she is at the moment, but that could all change very shortly when she gets back, so I thought I'd just better warn you all to be careful.
Careful of what?
Ellen has asked Lizzie to go over to America and live with them, which has lifted Lizzie's morale. Well, the trouble is, she won't get a visa because of her criminal record. No. Now, she's going to find out sooner or later, but until she's strong enough to take it, I suggest you all play along with her. Better still, avoid the issue altogether.
How soon will she be back here?
Should be in a couple of days.
Well, we'll keep it quiet, but what about you a lot?
What do you mean?
I reckon old Vera would blab in front of Lizzie just to see her collapse on the spot.
Well, don't you worry about Miss Bennett. I'll make sure she understands. There you are. Off to lunch with everybody.
Oh.
Where's Judy?
Gone for a walk in the bush. She'll be back directly.
Oh, I can't line this up and they'll be in the chair. Sit there for me, will you?
Look, Mickey, do you know what you're doing?
Of course I do. It's dead easy. The guys at the Uni explained. All you got to do is focus.
I'm not talking about the equipment.
What then?
I mean, getting mixed up in this campaign to reform the prison system. Look, it's one thing to walk up and down a road making a protest, but this is a whole lot more serious.
Yeah, well, the issues are a lot more serious.
You could be charged with aiding and abetting an escapee.
No, the other way round. The escapee is aiding and abetting me. Otherwise, I'd have no ammunition to fire at the authorities now, wouldn't I?
Just stop rationalising, please. You could go to jail for what you're doing.
Oh, yes, so could you.
I very much doubt it. Look, all I did was just put her up. I didn't even know her. She'll back me up on that.
Dad, you've always told me to stand up for what I believe in.
Well. Gee. What's all this, then?
Oh, thank goodness you're here. We try and talk some sense into this sentimental old fool of a father of mine.
Well, I've already talked to him, Mickey. He's right, you know. There's got to be another way.
There is no other way.
No, I'm sorry, honey. I've thought it over, and the interview is off.
Oh, Dorian, you're back early. Didn't take long.
How long does it take to say 2 years?
What, for the kidnapping?
No, the bust out. I got 3 months for the other.
Oh, hell, that's not too bad.
Yeah, well, Mrs. Davidson spoke up for me and Chrissy was real great. She told the judge, you know, how we all shared in looking after Elizabeth and how we all thought she was our own and stuff like that, you know?
Yeah. Pity we didn't get a chance to share in the fun before the kid came along.
Yeah. Oh, it looks like that sort of fun's out for me for a while too.
Well, it could be worse.
Yeah, but I didn't mind so much when I heard that great news about Lizzie this morning.
What did you hear?
Well, that she's going to America to live with Ellen and Josie.
Look, kid, you better prepare yourself for a shock.
Story about one of your friends in here.
Who?
Lizzie Birdsworth.
What's it say?
Nothing we don't already know, but apparently they picked it up from the television. They're going to run a campaign supporting a release.
Oh, well, there you go, the power of the media. Judy, please let me do this interview. Look, if it can work towards getting... If one of your friends a pardon, it could work towards getting changes you're looking for. Huh? So what do you say? Judy, please, the time's right. You'll never get another chance
no,
like this.
No, love, look, I've got to find another way.
Oh, yeah, when?
I don't know.
Well, I do, never. You'll never get another chance like this one.
You know how I feel about this, Judy.
Yeah, but you won't prevent it, though, will you? You can't. Because that would make a mockery out of everything you've ever taught me.
No, Mickey, I won't prevent it, but I won't support it either. It's your life, it's your decision.
Wait a minute. What if we posted the cassette to the television station? That way it could be made anywhere by anyone. I mean, they could never trace it. You can buy those cassettes at any department store.
Oh, yeah, you can, but... Now, that'd be too dangerous. The tape could fall into the wrong hands. It has to be delivered personally to Graham Hopkins.
Well, that means you.
Yeah, well, there's no one else.
Okay. All right. So you take the cassette to Hopkins, you give it to him personally, you don't say a word to anyone else, and then just get the hell out of there, huh?
Yeah, all right. Right. Oh, Dad, can I borrow the ute? That way I can hire a portable television set for tonight. We've got to keep abreast of what they're saying about us.
The keys are in the ignition.
Great, okay.
Now, hang on a minute, honey. Why don't you just go and get the television set? In the meantime, I'll put some words down on paper. If I'm going to do this, I'm going to do it right.
Yes, of course. All right.
Oh, thanks.
There you go. Right. Well, I'll see you later then.
Good.
Poor little door. 2 years and 3 months, you say?
Well, it could have been a lot worse, Lizzie.
Yeah, I know. Oh, if she's not careful, she's going to end up like me. Spend the best part of her life in clink.
Well, she has done a lot of foolish things. But don't you worry about Doreen. I'm going to take a special interest in her.
Yeah, and try and knock a bit of common sense into her.
Yes.
You know, I'm looking forward to getting out now and being with Ellen and Josie. That'll be hard leaving all my mates behind. But if they're in the hands of someone the likes of you, I don't suppose I've got very much to worry about. I know that you'll help them get their lives sorted out.
Thank you, Lizzie. I'll certainly do my best.
I know you will. Do you reckon that you could do me a small favour?
Well, of course, if I can.
I've never had a passport before. And if I'm going to be jet-setting around the world...
Well, now, what's all this about jet-setting?
Oh, good day, Doc. I didn't see you there. This is Mrs. Davidson. She's the governor of Wentworth. This is Dr. Marsden. He's a nice young bloke, but his bills are bloody awful. You should see the diet he's got me on. I reckon he thinks I'm a rabbit.
How do you do, Doctor?
Nice to meet you, Mrs. Davidson. Now, Lizzie, what's all this business about passports and jet-setting?
I'm going to be living with me daughter and a new husband.
Yes, I understand that, but why the passport?
Well, they're in America. She had to take Josie over there for a treatment.
Lizzie, let's get you well first, and then we'll worry about that, okay? Mrs. Davidson, I wonder if I could see you for a
moment. Yes, certainly.
Excuse us, Lizzie.
Of course. Go for your life.
I realise that Lizzie will have to be told sooner or later, but quite frankly, I'd rather it be later. However, you're the heart specialist, so could you tell me what effect it would have on her if we told her now?
No, it could be dangerous. I mean, there's no doubt that the prospect of going to see her daughter has been a major contributing factor in her recovery. Take that away from her now, it could be... Well, it could be harmful.
To say the least. Well, Doctor, I don't like lying to Lizzie. So, could you think of something to tell her without her having a major heart attack?
Oh, now, look, I'm sorry. I can't guarantee you that.
Well, we'll just have to go along with the deception for the time being, at least.
Mm. And she's going to want to know what we've been talking about out here. I'll have to tell her something.
Well, you could tell her that, in your opinion, you don't think she's strong enough to travel.
Well, I came in just now to tell her that I thought she'd be ready for discharge tomorrow.
Well, let's get her back with her friends, and then you could also add that you think she ought to convalesce for a while, and then when she's stronger, I'll tell her the truth.
Okay. Oh, goodbye, Mrs. Davidson.
So, what happens to Lizzie Birdsworth now? The latest news from the hospital is that she's making a fair recovery and should be discharged from the cardiac ward within the next day or so. From there, Lizzie will be transferred back to the grim confines of the Wentworth Detention Centre, which itself has been the centre of some controversy over recent days.
Yeah, that's for sure.
We'll keep you posted on events as they develop. And now, on a less serious note, we have a story...
That hasn't left the door wide open for us. You got your speech ready?
Ready.
All right. Let's get going.
morning.
Oh, good morning, good Mrs. morning. Davidson.
I think we should have quite a short meeting this morning. Now then, let's see what's on the agenda.
Before we start, we've had a message through from the department. They've approved the appointment of Sid Humphrey as general handyman.
Oh, a bit quick off the mark, weren't they?
Yes, for a change.
Yes, well now, this is the diet chart. Lizzie will be back with us later today, and Dr. Marsden wants her to vary her eating habits a little. Would you see the cook gets that, and if she does have any objections, which I have no doubt she will, refer her to me.
How is she?
Amazingly well.
So she hasn't been told about the visa restrictions yet?
No, Dr. Marsden and I had a long chat about that yesterday and decided to wait until she's convalesced for a while.
She is aware of the media campaign, though, isn't she?
Oh, yes, but she's not expecting any immediate results from that. She realizes it will take time.
Well, how long?
Well, the longer the better, if you ask me.
Yes, give her time to work up her strength before we give her the bad news. Perhaps I should have said before I give her the bad news. Now then, is there any news of Judy Bryant?
No, nothing yet.
Yeah, but couldn't I speak to her personally?
No way, Mr. Hopkins. No, we've got Judy on videotape and she's made a statement. We want that statement to go to her as it is, no edits.
Look, just hang on a minute. What did you say your name is?
I didn't, I'm not going to. Now, do you want the tape or don't you?
Yes, I want the tape.
And you play it as it is, no edits?
As it is. Where's the tape now?
Oh, I'll have it in a safe place.
Okay. Now, can you get it to me here at the channel?
No way, Mr. Hopkins. You'll have the police and all the rest of them waiting for me. Next thing I know, I'm the one on the hot seat.
All right. I'll meet you somewhere.
Fine. You used to play football, didn't you?
Yeah, but what's that got to do with it?
Well, I'm just hoping you haven't forgotten how to mark, that's all. Do you know the car park in the supermarket just around the corner from you?
Yeah, I know it.
Well, I'll meet you there at 3 p.m. sharp. Come on your own, OK?
Yeah, sure, but...
Are a bloody parliamentarian. Stupid bloody wheelchair. I've had a heart attack. I haven't had my bloody legs amputated. How are you two buggers?
We're fine, thanks, Lizzie. Enough of that language, eh?
Oh, it's enough to make a trooper swear. Can I get out of this contraption? Thank you.
Well, how are you, love? You enjoying married life?
Yes, thank you, Lizzie. Will you do the paperwork, Jim?
Yes, sure.
Now, you sit down here whilst your papers are being processed, and then you can go and put your feet up.
Oh, I'm all right. I want to go down the laundry and talk to my mates, tell them all about my trip to America.
Yes. Well, you can pop in and say a quick hello, but then I think it's into the cot for you.
But Dr. Marsden said that I needed a little light exercise. And have you heard about me diet? They're going to put me on some good food.
Yes, Lizzie, it's all been arranged. And as for your exercise, you're allowed to take a gentle walk in the garden whenever you feel up to it.
Oh, that'll be nice. Oh, they tell me that Jude's still on the run.
Yes. Yes, she is.
Oh, good on her.
Now, listen. You see anyone that even looks like a cop, you clear the hell out of the place, understand?
Yeah, I'll be right. There shouldn't be too many people in the car park this time of day. If there's anybody other than Hopkins, I'll be able to spot them. You just watch me make this old you travel.
Not too fast, eh?
Right.
There you take care of.
W. Damn. Still, that might be enough. I might just contact you first, miss. whoever you are.
All right, so the cassette's transferred to 2-inch. Then what?
Well, they'll be put it to air as part of our Wentworth program.
Yeah, well, can't be tonight. We're already locked into a full program.
Well, tomorrow night will be just fine. By then, I should have a personal interview with this Judy Bryant and hopefully the people who are helping her.
Now, come on, Graham. If you know where this Judy Bryant is, you should tell the police now.
No way, Martin, no way. I tell them now and they'll come flat-footing around here and scare them all off.
So you do know where she is?
Not exactly, but I'm working on it. And I don't want the police barging
now,
in here.
I know we have to be controversial to keep ahead in the ratings, but I will not go outside the law. We would get nowhere without cooperation from the police.
Martin, just let me get this interview in the can, will you, huh? Hell, the woman's been on the loose for days. Another 24 hours isn't going to make any difference.
All right. I'll give you 24 hours. Then what?
We have this tape and the interview with Bryant. That'll give us a double scoop. Then we can tell the police everything.
Okay, 24 hours. But not a minute more.
I won't let you down, Martin, I promise. Val? Val? It's Graham Hopkins. Look, that registration number I gave you, did you? Yes, I know I only gave you the prefix, but surely the fact that it's a 1963 Holden Ute order... Yeah, okay. Keep trying.
Well, 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 how's the invalid today?
Ha ha! Not too much of the bloody invalid. Do you know I've walked 3 times around the garden, Savo?
Geez, next thing you know, you'll be competing in the next Olympic Games.
Yeah, I'll be in America by then. Do you reckon that'll make me a Yank?
Yeah. I see you got the fresh fruit.
Yeah. Who sent that in? There was just a note saying, to Lizzie with love, and no name, no nothing.
Oh, well, we all chipped in. Mrs. Davidson fixed it for old Sid to go out and buy it for us.
Oh, thanks. Who's Sid?
Oh, an old fellow that came in to fix the telly while you're away. Nice old bloke, and we've arranged things so he can be around a bit more often.
How? Oh, a bit of harmless sabotage, you know?
You can't call sabotage harmless, Doreen. Anyway, I think sabotage is the wrong word.
Well, what would you call it then?
Oh, I don't know. How about breakdown assistance?
Yeah.
Just making sure that a few things that are bound to go wrong sooner or later are...
Yeah, and we're speeding things up a bit. Yeah. Want to be in it?
Oh, yeah. I'll go troppo, just sitting here on me own. Besides, it'll give me a bit of a chance to have a go at the screws before my release comes through. Yeah, well, look, this is what we've got up to so far.
And that all three are believed to be the work of the same person, as the identical means of starting the fire, petrol-soaked rags in the storeroom, was
what
used
time
on
is
each
it?
Occasion.
Nearly 5:30. What yeah, we'll see the bastard's not going to show it. I mean, this program's almost over. The cassette I sent in is more than 5 minutes.
I said I had to go to air tonight.
Well, maybe the police got hold of it, huh? I mean, they might have set up an injunction. I did lay into the administration a bit.
No, I think he's still got the tape. He's just not playing it for some reason.
Well, how can you be sure?
Well, if there was an official ban on it going to air, he would have said something about it.
What is he trying to do?
Before I go, I've just been handed a message advising that Lizzie Birdsworth, our heartbreak inmate, has been returned to the Wentworth Detention Centre. Lizzie, if you're watching, God bless you. You keep your chin up. There are a lot of people working on your behalf. So from me again, it's Graham Hopkins wishing you a good night.
Well, that's it then.
Yeah, that's it. Oh, incidentally, Lizzie Birdsworth has been sent back to prison. End of story, end of campaign.
No, it isn't. He's got the tape. I think I know why he didn't show it.
Why?
Oh, when I spoke to him, he tried to pry me from a name and address. He wanted to come out personally in interviews. He's after an interview with him firing the questions, and obviously he's not going to show the tape unless he gets it.
Well, he's already got the cassette.
But he's not going to show it.
Well, I'm not going to do an interview. That would be too dangerous.
Nice of Mr. Hopkins to tell us you're back with us, Lizzie.
Oh, don't knock him, B. He's doing a good job.
Yeah, for himself from the television station he works for. Anyway, that show is over for tonight, and now on with the real entertainment.
Hey, Mouse, did you get all that stuff I asked you to get from the kitchen, rubber gloves and what have you?
Yeah. Do you want them now?
Yeah, gimme.
What you gonna do, Bee?
We are going to drum up a little extra trade for our old friend Sid.
Oh, that's the sabotage.
Now, I thought we decided not to use that word. No, not in here. The ceiling's too high in the storeroom. Hey, May, keep knit, will you? Oh, God, you could have folded it.
Well, I suppose I could have, but I still...
Never mind. Doreen, stand by the switch, will you?
What are you gonna do, Bee?
Well, someone should tell her, and the sooner the better.
We'll give her time to build up some strength. The woman's likely to have a heart attack on the spot, and this time she mightn't recover.
Precisely. And whose fault would that be? If it was up to me, I would never have led her on like this. The moment that letter came in, I would have told her not to build up her hopes.
But what about a recovery? Now, you can't deny that the thought of starting a new life again in America helped her enormously.
So now she's recovered. Someone has to tell her the truth, even if they run the risk of causing a relapse. She's 72 years of age. How much strength do you think she's going to build up? Oh, at least if we'd been honest with her from the outset, she would have had the benefit of the best medical attention. It was there, on hand. Now she's not only been taken out of intensive care, she's been discharged from the hospital altogether.
All right, Vera, you've made your point. Unfortunately, when these things happen, you can't always... What the hell?
What's that?
Main fuse must have gone. Hello, Colleen. Yes, the same thing's happened here. Has your emergency lighting come on yet? Good. Look, could you ask all the officers to report to their stations and get all the women locked away into their cells? We can't have them wandering around this half light. Right, good.
Better take these in case the backup goes on us as well.
Moonlight's having a bad effect on Vera.
Well, no, quietly down, you lot. The main fuse is blown, that's all. We're going to have to stay on emergency lighting until it's fixed. In the meantime, we'll have to get to yourselves. No arguments. Now, come on, get the moving lights about here.
Can't you fix the main fuse, Mr. Fletcher?
No, I can't.
We'll have to get Sid to fix it.
Sid will fix it in the morning when he comes in.
Have you called him already?
No, I haven't, but he'll be here in the morning anyway.
How come if you haven't called him?
Because he was appointed General Handyman this morning. Now, would you get into your cells?
Oh, heck. Bloody hell!
What's wrong, Bee? What's wrong, she says? What's wrong? Look, I don't mind being put to bed at this time of night if it means getting Sid a bit of extra work, but if he's already got the job, well, where's the value in that?
Yeah, the cape has gone and backfired on us.
Oh, bloody hell.
When the lights went out, my first thought was sabotage. I thought, good God, not another escape. When I checked the master system, I found that the main fuse had blown. I suppose I could have fixed it myself, but I really couldn't be bothered. Now, look, when that handyman arrives, could you ask him... Yes?
I'm him.
Him who?
Yeah, I'm him you were just talking about just now. I'm Sid Humphrey, your new handyman.
Sid. Jim Fletcher, Deputy Governor. Pleased to meet you.
Yeah.
We could have done with you last night. All the lights went. Now that you're here, I'll get you to take a look at it. We've got a few other jobs lined up for you as well. Julie here will give you the list. Julie, could you arrange for someone to take Sid to the main fuse box, please? Look, I'm off duty now, Sid. I'll catch up with you later.
Yeah, listen, I'm not a certified electrician, you know.
Oh, that's all right. It's only a fuse.
G'day. Hey. You're that woman, aren't you?
What woman?
You know, the one that they were talking about on the telly.
Oh, yeah, that's me.
Yeah. I showed a photo of you. What's your name again?
Lizzie Birdsworth.
That's right. Well, I'm Sid. Sid Humphrey.
G'day, Sid.
Yeah, one of my grandchildren's called Elizabeth.
Is she? What are all the others called?
Oh, Bryden, Scott, David, Josie, and Beth. That's short for Elizabeth.
That's funny. My granddaughter's called Josie.
Well, wait till I tell them that.
Yeah. I suppose you realise that we really got you your job here, you know.
How do you mean?
Well, me and a few of the others, we buggered up the taps and last night... We fused all the lights.
Oh, hey, you want to be careful. You can get an awful boot from fiddling around with electricity, you know.
Oh, it was okay. We wore rubbed gloves.
You just as well you did.
You can bring your grandchildren to see me if you like. Oh,
I don't suppose their parents would like that.
Oh, no, that'll be fine. The trouble is, they live so far away.
Oh, what a shame. I really do love kids.
Good. Yeah, maybe you can come and visit them when you get out. You know, when this campaign thing's all over, they're supposed to be coming for a visit.
Well, no. When I get out, I'm going to live with my daughter and my granddaughter in America. You know, Josie.
Oh, I see. Getting preferential treatment because you're a television star, eh?
What do you mean, preferential treatment?
Well, you'd have to have diplomatic immunity or something, wouldn't you? Otherwise, the Yanks wouldn't let you in the country.
Why not?
Well, I was reading in a magazine a while back. They're getting a bit choosy about who they let in. You're right out if you've got a criminal record. Didn't you know? Lizzie? You dropped your book.
Hopkins. Yes, a Holden News. What? Yeah. Yeah? That's gotta be the one. Thanks, Val. I love you madly.
You going out?
Yeah, I think I've got a lead on Judy Bryant.
Ah.
Ah, what?
You could be a bit late.
What are you driving at?
I changed my mind, Graham. Thought it over last night.
Come on, Martin. You changed your mind about what?
About giving it 24 hours.
You didn't... You haven't told the cops, have you?
Phoned them this morning.
On the tape, Bryant's statement?
Sent them a copy as soon as I got in here.
You bloody idiot.
Now, where are you going?
To try and salvage something out of this schmozzle.
Wait, Graham, you can't leave now. The police are on their way here. They want to talk to you.
Stuff them.
Excuse me, Mr. Davidson.
Yes, Mr. Fletcher. I thought you'd gone home. Weren't you on night shift?
Yes, I was. I popped home, had a shower, some breakfast, and then came back for a double shift.
Well, things must be bad if the deputy governor can't organise his time off.
Yes, well, Lizzie Birdsworth wants to see you. I think she's found out.
Well, you'd better bring her in.
Right. Come on, Lizzie.
Thank you, Mr. Fletcher.
Well, Lizzie, what's the problem?
I want some answers, Mrs. Davidson. And I want them straight and honest.
I've always tried to be straight with all of you.
All right, Ben. What's this about them Yanks banning ex-convicts?
Immigration policies change from country to country. Sometimes even from government to government.
Does that mean that that president bloke can put the lid on me going to live with my own daughter?
No, not necessarily the president personally. He doesn't make all the decisions. He has a Congress, a group of elected citizens to help him.
And they've said that ex-cons can't go to America?
Yes, Lizzie, that is the law.
And you knew all the time. And you didn't tell me. You knew and you kept it from me.
Well, it was for your own good. I wanted to wait until you were stronger.
What am I going to do, Mrs. Davidson? What am I going to do?
Well, you could write a letter to Ellen and tell her you can't come over there. And you never know, she might come home to Australia with her new husband.
No, I'm not going to let her spoil her life on my account. I'll think up something to say why I can't come. And at least I know they'll be happy.
Lizzie, before you go, who told you about the immigration restrictions?
It was Sid, the handyman. But he didn't mean any harm, honest.
All right, Lizzie. You better go and get some rest.
Yeah. Thank you, Mrs. Davidson. And I don't hold nothing against you for not telling me. I know you only did it because you were thinking of me old ticker, that's all. I'll be okay.
Hi.
Hi.
So why don't we take a walk and find a nice quiet spot by the river?
Okay.
Great. We'll be back for lunch a bit later. Come on.
Anyhow, after the scandal broke, Barbara killed herself. The whole town seemed to be waiting to find out what I was going to do, you know? My parents weren't much help. They'd never even met a lesbian, let alone imagine their daughter as one. So I did the only thing I could do. I got as far away from the place as I could. I went to Melbourne. That's far, eh? Anyway, it wasn't much difference here, so I just traveled around for a while, you know? Then I settled in Melbourne. I drove a cab for years. And then I met Sharon. She was something special, you know? She's only a kid, but, wow. Well, everything was great for a while, and she got involved with drugs. Oh, I don't mean hard stuff, anything like that, but it was, I hated it. I warned her. I told her she'd get busted, but...
She got caught.
Oh, yeah. And that's how I got in Wentworth.
Why? Because she got caught.
Well, you see, when she got caught, she thought I was going to pay all the legal expenses, you know, or the bail and everything like that, but I wouldn't. I said to her, no, this will teach her a lesson. I thought she'd get away with it, you know, just a fine or a warning, something like that. Good behavior. I didn't know she'd get 2 years. So I decided that I'd get arrested to be with her.
Well, how'd you manage that?
I took in some drugs when I went to visit her, knowing they'd search me. Anyway, she wasn't nice anymore. She wasn't nice to me. And then she got killed by a screw.
You're joking.
I'm not. I wish I was. You know something, they couldn't prove it? He just got transferred. He's out here walking around somewhere.
God, that's awful.
Yeah. Anyway, that was 2 deaths. Then there was Leanne. She was a good kid. And then there was Irene, the one in the tunnel I told you about. I mean, they weren't lovers or anything like that. They were just my friends, and they were bloody good friends. Now they're dead. Mickey, I really appreciate everything you've done for me. I hope we'd be good friends. It's just that 4 people are dead because of me.
Come on, you can't blame yourself.
Yeah, I know, I didn't push them. But they were involved with me and I was involved with them. I just don't want any more friends on my conscience. Okay?
Well, come on, you ladies. Didn't you hear the bell? Move. Go on. Hurry.
Let's go and see what gourmet delights have got in line for Lizzie today.
Yeah. Hey, Lizzie. You all right, love? Come on, what's the matter?
Me trip to America. It's been all shot to pieces. As if a body hadn't paid enough. I admit I've done some bloody dreadful things in my time, but I've paid my debt to society, and now society's gone and fouled everything up. It's just not fair. It's not fair.
Oh, come on, love. How'd you find out?
Sid told me. Then I went and asked Mrs. Davids. She said the same thing.
Oh, I'm sorry, love. Look, I know it must be a hell of a shock for you, but... You've got to let this get you down, are you? You've got too much guts for that.
Yeah, and we'll help you, won't we, B?
Of course we will.
Yeah, you still got your mates, Lizzie.
No, I haven't. Since that bloody doctor stuck his nose in. So I'm going to get out soon, and then I won't have no one.
Doreen, come with me.
Why shouldn't we stay with...
I said, come with me.
Not yet. Dan, the TV guy Hopkins, he must have traced me.
Cops.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Well, that's the way we see it, Mrs. Davidson. We think if she's left on her own, it could kill her.
These are very determined people, Smith. They already have a great deal of support from the public.
You're saying there's nothing you can do?
No, I will speak to Dr. Marsden. I'm sure he'll see the wisdom of leaving Lizzie where she is. His only concern is for Lizzie. However, we still have this Hopkins fellow to contend with.
Yeah, he doesn't give a damn about Lizzie.
Precisely. Lizzie is topical at the moment, as is Judy Bryant while she's still at large. I'm afraid it might be difficult to get him to forego his ratings in favour of humanitarianism.
You will have a go, though, won't you?
Yes, I will. I am aware of the problems Lizzie faces on the outside, and I shall do everything in my power to ensure that whatever happens to her in the future will be in her best interests.
Thanks again, Mrs. Davidson. We'll leave it with you, then.
Yeah, thanks. Fine. Thank you, Miss Bennett. Judy, would you get Dr. Marsden for me, please?
God, I wish I could hear what they were saying.
Don't worry, my man's got his wits about him.
No, he's gone far enough now. I should have never involved you two in the first place. I know it. I'm giving myself up.
Don't be stupid. They wouldn't do anybody any good. They'd just put you back in Wentworth and that'd be the end of everything. Let's move a bit closer and see what they're saying.
Look, I've just been trying to explain to this girl that people... I always use my ute around this place here. That's why I leave the keys in the ignition, you see? I mean, it's quite simple if you think about it.
Lizzie, are you all right?
What's it to you?
We're all a bit worried about you and...
What?
I just wanted you to know that I think you're showing a lot of courage to take all this the way you have.
What do you expect me to do? Curl up in the corner and die? Is that what you're waiting for now? Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, Miss Bennett, but you had your chance to watch me die when I had my last attack. But you had to stick your bloody bib
in... Whatever you think of me, Lizzie... I don't want to see you die. I had to watch my own mother and... Oh, never mind. Might just help you to know that you do have a lot of friends who really care about you.
Yeah, you're not one of them.
If you need anything, just ask.
Well, you know they're going to check his background. They're going to ask him a lot of questions. They'll go right through him. It's only a matter of time. They'll find out he had a daughter, and then they'll be on to you.
Well, they can't prove that I took the tape to them.
Oh, maybe not now they can't. But you keep fighting my battles for me, honey, and they'll find you sooner or later. I got to fight this battle myself, Mickey.
Well, how can you manage of your own? Where are you going to go?
I don't know. Heck, I got $1,000 here. What are you talking about? I'll be all right. I'll set myself up somewhere and then you never know, huh?
Judy, I wish you'd think it over.
I have thought it over, Mickey, and my mind is made up.
Judy, please, look, we can go into the city. I've got at least a dozen friends who'll set you up, and well, when things settle down, we can have another try. You want to get those changes to the system, don't you?
Yes, but I...
Well, then?
I'm afraid not, honey. Look, I gotta go and do this myself. You've been terrific, and I really appreciate everything you've done, but it's my battle, okay? You look after yourself, yeah?
Dreamed we were together. Share